So last class we see about the DC fundamentals. It includes basic definitions of voltage, current, resistance, resistivity, and basic laws of electrical circuits, Ohm's law, Kirchhoff's law. So it contains two laws. One is Kirchhoff current law and Kirchhoff voltage law. So in this class we see about the AC fundamentals. AC in the sense alternating current. So generally the DC source gives the a steady state value of the output current irrespective of the time. But in AC, the current varies with respect to time. So it can be represented by the three ways. One is RMS value, average value, and then peak value. So now see about the how the alternating EMF is generated. So here the generation of alternating EMF. So the EMF is generated the basic principle of Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. So first we see the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. So this is a one coil, or it is a conductor, it formed as a coil or loop, and this is a magnet, it having north pole and south pole. When the conductor is stationary and the magnet is movement. If the magnet is moved towards the coil, the flux linkages around the conductor is varying. So due to the flux linking with the conductor changes, the EMF is induced in that coil. That is indicated by the galvanometer. When the magnet moving inside the coil, it gives the deflection on positive sides. If we pulling outside the coil, it indicates negative sign. When the magnet is stationary with respect to this coil, the current galvanometer here indicates zero, that is no induced EMF. So from that we conclude, when the motion of the conductor is present, then the EMF induced in that conductor. When the magnet is stationary, then there no EMF induced in the current. When the EMF is increased by increasing the velocity of the motion, by moving inwards and outwards very fastly, and faster movement, the rate of flux linkages around the conductor is changing fastly, so the induced EMF is largely produced. So it can be represented by the equation is equal to minus n into d phi by dt. So it is also measured by the unit of volts. Here the E indicates the generated voltage or EMF, and n the number of coil turns, flux, so number of flux linking with that coil with respect to time. Here in this equation we write E is equal to minus n into d phi by dt. This minus indicates the produced EMF will oppose the cause of producing it, that is represented by Lenz's law. So as per the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, we can derive induced EMF E equal to minus n into d phi by dt. Here we are using one conductor and one magnet and then medium. We can set any one as stationary and other one is moving. With respect to these two elements, we can create the speed. So with respect to this, one is motion. One is stationary, another one is moving. So it has relative movement. It has relative moment. Now we see the single loop generators, how the AC waveform is produced. Here the requirements is magnet and conductor and then medium. Here two rings, this is called slip rings P and Q. So from that ring we can take the supply from the coils. So this is the galvanometer to indicates the value. So P and Q are brushes. The darked block surface is called brushes. from that, because it is revolving, so that we can get the supply from the brush contact with the rings. So we can get the supply from the brushes. So here north pole, south pole, so in this place the magnetic field is created. So in the magnetic field the conductor is placed. So A, B, C, D is the conductor. So the end points of the conductor is connected to the slip rings. So from the slip rings we take the output voltage by pressures. Now the flux lines are moving from N to S and cut the conductor ABCD. Now the ABCD is vertical to the flux lines, that means maximum flux lines cut the conductor, but rate of flux linkages is minimum. So the EMF initially zero, so vertical position is say as a, it is a 0 degree, then it moves clockwisely 10 degree 20 degree. Like when moving, the rate of flux linkages also changes, so the EMF is induced in that conductor. So when it reaches the 90 degree, so the it is parallel to the magnet, then the induced EMF in the induced EMF in the conductor is maximum, but here the number of flux lines is minimum and the rate of flux linkages is maximum, so that we attain 90 degree maximum value of magnitude, that is represented by E maximum, and then again it starts rotating and then it reduces the value and then it comes to again vertical. Here the induced EMF zero, again it starts rotating, it gives the negative half cycle. At 270 degree it again get the maximum value, again 360 degree, so it is repeated by repeated alternate with respect to time. So this is called one cycle. This one is 0 to 180 degree, this is called positive half cycle. So 180 to 360, this is called negative half cycle. This totally, this is called one cycle. So this, in this way, the EMF or alternating voltage or current is produced. This is a simple loop generator. And next we see about the what is the indication parameters for the alternating current or voltage. So one is RMS value, average value, and then peak value. So here the RMS value is the steady state value of the current, which when flowing through the circuit for a given time produces the same amount of heat as would be produced by the alternate current producing through it. Because in DC it is a steady state current, so the effective value that is equal to the steady state current we can easily define. But in AC it is varying with respect to time, so we have to find effective value. So effective value is nothing but the RMS value. So the RMS value is determined by two ways. One is graphical approach. If you take one sine wave, one half cycle of the sine wave, if with respect to time base we can divide into number of portions and each portion take the midpoint, and I1 if it is a current as a magnitude, this is I1, this is I2, likewise this is In. Now take the area under the curve, so we get I RMS square, that is equal to this I1 square plus I2 square up to number of divided parts divided by number of portions. So we take the root of this equation, we get the RMS equation or RMS value of the sinusoidal waveform. So next we can arrive this by analytical point also. So analytically we can derive, so analytically at any instant of time the current is defined I, that is equal to Im, that is maximum value of current, into sin omega t. So we can take omega t as a theta, so I is equal to Im into sin theta. So now we find the RMS value. So RMS is nothing but a root mean square value. So first take mean square value is, that is equal to mean square value of current equal to 1 by time period 0 to time period into I into dt. In this we can take full, in this we take full cycle, that means so the mean square value of current I, that is equal to 1 by t integration of 0 to t I into dt. Here we take full cycle, so t is equal to 2 pi, so 0 to 2 pi, and I is Im sin theta into d theta. Now Im by 2 pi, so the RMS value of the given waveform can be find out by analytically. So here I is equal to at any instant of time Im sin omega t. So we can write I is equal to Im sin theta. So the mean square value, that is equal to 1 by t integration of 0 to t I square dt. So here Im squared into we get sin square theta Im squared. Now we can simplify this 0 to 2 pi 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by dt. So we can take outside 2, so Im squared by 4 pi, and then we differentiate integrate with respect to theta. So theta minus here sin 2 theta divided by 2, the limit is 2 pi. So we substitute the limits, then we arrive, that is 2 pi, remaining are zeros because sin 2 pi is 0. So 0, if we substitute another limit 0, we can get 0. So 2 pi, if we cancel, we get Im square by 2. Now take the, this is a square value of current. So we take IRMS, we find IRMS to take the root of this mean value of the current. So we get Im by root 2. So this is the RMS value of the current. In the same way, we can arrive the RMS value of the voltage equal to Vm by root 2. Or we can say easily 0.1 by root 2 is 0.707 Vm, same 0.707 Im. So this is RMS value of current and RMS value of voltage. This is one indication of the AC parameter. So next parameter is the average value. So the average value of an AC is given by that the steady state current which transfer across the circuit, the same charge as would be transferred by the AC across the same circuit at the same time. So this is the definition of RMS value. This is also determined basically in two ways. One is graphical approach and another one is analytical approach. If we graphically means, if we take the half of the waveform, so this we can divide with respect to time many portions, and each portion take a midpoint and marked as, if the magnitude is I means I1, I2, I3, I4 like, and take the average, I average, that is equal to I1 plus I2 up to In divided by N. This is a nothing but the area of the area under the curve. So I1 plus I2 up to In divided by number of portions. In this way we can arrive the average value, and analytically also we can derive the average value. Here the average value, that is I average, that is equal to, so 1 by t integration of 0 to t I dt. So 1 by t, here we can take There is a half wave symmetry, so we can take half of the waveform from one cycle. If I this is 0 pi by 2, this is y, I take 0 to pi, then t is 0 to pi, and then I is at any instant of time, that is Im sine theta into dt. So this Im by pi. So if we integrate sine theta, we get minus cos theta 0 to pi. Then we substitute the limit. So I average, we get 2 Im by pi. So this is the average value of AC current. If it is a voltage in the sense V average, that is equal to 2 Vm by pi. Here Im is maximum value of current and Vm is maximum value of voltage. So next, the peak value is the highest value of the waveform or in the magnitude. This is called peak value of the waveform. And the average value, RMS value and the peak value is related by using the two parameters. One is the form factor and another one is a peak factor. So here the form factor is defined as the ratio between the RMS value and average value. So for the pure sinusoid, if it is a pure sinusoidal waveform, if the RMS value is already we derived, that is if current means, that is Im by root 2, average value means we can get 2 Im by pi. So we can get solve 1.11. This is a form factor for pure sinusoidal waveform. If it is a peak factor, in the sense the ratio between the peak value and the RMS value. So if it is a current means, the peak value of current is Im and RMS value is Im by root 2. So that is equal to root 2 equal to 1.414. This is a peak factor for the pure sinusoidal waveform. Here we assume the waveform is pure sinusoidal without any distortions. So next we see the what are the different powers are available in the different so next we see the what are the different powers in the electrical supply. So sir, there are three classify the power into three categories. One is apparent power, reactive power and active power. So first one is active power. Active power is nothing but a true power. That means originally the device consumed by the in a power flow, there are three categories of power. So one is apparent power and another one is reactive power and another one is true power or active power. So true power or active power, in the sense the device originally consumed power, that is called true power. And next one is reactive power. So reactive power, in the sense it is not originally consumed by the any device or any machine, it is called circulating current. So if the transmission line or in any machine or in any device, the inductive and the capacitive components are present. So the inductive capacitive components, it is charging and discharging. So the current is charging and then discharging. It is circulating around the conductors or transmission line. It is not converted into the any useful work. So that power is called reactive power. Or otherwise we can say that is power delivered by the load. We can say that is reactive power. So this is a wasteful power or useless power, like we can say this is a circulating in the circuit or the transmission line or the machine. It is not converted into the any useful power. And the combination of the active and reactive power is called apparent power. Now this is a power triangle, this right angle triangle. In this part is called P. P is nothing but a real power and Q is a reactive power and S is a apparent power. So this is a right angle triangle. So the power we defined VI cos phi. P is defined VI cos phi. That we can write here the apparent power is S equal to V into I. From that s into cos theta, or otherwise we can term I squared r, then the unit of real power or active power or true power, that is equal to watts, and the unit of reactive power is volt ampere reactive, VAR, that is denoted by VI sin theta or I squared x. This is the reactive values. So here it is a resistor, in reactive power it is mentioned as x, it may be inductive or capacitive. Next one is apparent power, that is I squared r, that is equal to I squared z. So z is a like r plus jx, so it is a impedance, it a combination of both resistive and reactive values. So z is a apparent power, r is a real power, x is a reactive components. So this is a classification of different powers in the loads, in any loads. Now we see the simple problems, we can understand these different powers. This is a 600 volts supplied to the three elements, one is lamp loads and another one is electrical furnace and another one is a three phase induction motor. Here the supply voltage is 600 volt AC. Here the lamp load, the consumption, the power of the load is 12 kilowatt only. The electrical furnace is the power 2.4 plus J 3.2 ohm. The induction motor having the 80 kilowatts and it is 0.8 power factor lagging. So it lamp load only consumes the real power only, it does not have any reactive power. So for the lamp load we can say the real power P, that is equal to the given specification is 12 kilowatt, we can slightly write 12 kilowatts. So the reactive power for lamp load, that is Q, that is equal to 0. This is for lamp load. Next we see the electrical furnace, it is giving 2.4 and 3.2, like this is R plus JX. Next is the electrical furnace load. So electrical furnace having the two components, one is real part is 2.4 ohm and reactive part is 3.2 ohms. The supply voltage is 600 volt. These are all connected in parallel, so the voltage is same in parallel circuit. From that we can calculate current. So the current becomes 150 ampere. So the power, real power in the electric furnace, that is equal to I squared into R, that is equal to 150 square into the value of R is 2.4, that is 54 kilowatts. Next, the reactive power of the electrical furnace, that is Q, equal to I squared into X, that is 150 squared into 3.2, that is equal to 75 kVAR. And for the three phase induction motor, it is giving, in three phase induction motor, the real power, that is P, equal to directly given 80 kilowatts. So the motor having the coils, so definitely the motor having some inductive reactive elements. So it given the detail 0.8 power factor lagging. So from that we can find the angle of the motor, because power factor, that is equal to cos theta, that is 0.8. From that we can find the value of theta, that is cos inverse of 0.8. So the value becomes 36.9 degree. Now come to the power triangle. This is a angle and this is a real power, this is reactive power. From that we can write the, sorry, this is a reactive power. From that we can write tan theta equal to Q by P. From that Q, that is equal to P tan theta. So we know the value of real power and we know the value of theta. We can substitute, then we get 30 kVAR. This is the reactive power of the three phase induction motor. than the total real power that is consumed by the all the three elements, that is from the lamp it is 12 kilowatt, and from electrical furnace the real power is 54 kilowatt, and the real power of three phase induction motor, that is 80 kilowatts. So totally 146 kilowatt, that is a total real power consumed in this circuit. And total reactive power, the reactive power contributed by the lamp load is 0 kilowatts, and electrical furnace is 72 kVAr kilowatt reactive, and three phase induction motor having the reactive power of 60. So total 132 kVAr. So this is the three types of powers in the AC circuits.